Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In the previous video I just created for this home page. If you don't see that video, just go to description and check out the link. Okay, so in this video I'm going to create for this add new donor part. Okay, so let's start. We are creating a new JFrame for this add new donor. Okay, clicking on finish. Now we have to increase the size to the 700 and 500. Finish. And after that we have also have to remove the min, max and close button from this form, and we also have to set for the event and component, so because we have to also load something in this project. Now we have to design this form. Okay, so first we need a label here, and let me edit this text. Here I'm adding add new donor. Okay, now we have to increase the size of this, making it as bold 36, and we are also changing the text design to this. Okay, close. Now we have to set here at the center. And after that we are using a line in this one is known as separator in this. Okay, let me increase the size to this. Now separator, you can see a line has been created. Okay, now we need a level here, level to display the donor ID. Okay, then get removed. New donor ID. Okay, after that we need another level to display the donor ID. Okay, so let me edit this, and I'm just setting to the 1 right now. After that we also going to increase the size of this so that it can be visible easily. Okay, making the bold, and we are also changing to the 18. Okay, close. Now we are also increasing the size of this and making it bold 14. Okay, and we are changing the donor ID color to the red so that it can look good. Foreground ground color, we are setting it to red. Okay, close. Now we need here another level here for to get the name from user, full name. Okay, after full name we need a level for the father's name. Edit text, father name. After that we need another label for mother name. Okay, mother name. After mother name we need a label for date of birth, DOB. Edit text, date of birth. Okay, after DOB, date of birth, you can say we are taking name or sorry, mobile number. After mobile number we are taking from user gender. Okay, edit text, gender. Okay, now for these fields we are also need text field, and the every first one is for text field. For the father's name we are also taking text field 2, and for the mother name we are also taking the text field. For the DOB we are choosing the date chooser here. Okay, I also created a video to how to take a date in your field and all, So if you don't seen that video, just go to my JFrame tutorial and you can check there at how just added this JFrame in our swing controls. Okay, after that we need a mobile number. So for that we are also taking the text field here, and for the gender we are using combo box. Okay, now increasing the size of this all to the I'm setting to 150, no, I'm taking to 162. Let me also increase the size of this also. Let me make them all same. Okay, let me edit the text. Edit text. Let me also remove this and removing all the text from this. And for this, we are setting here. Just remove the item. I said male, female, and others. Okay. Okay, close this. Now we are making this full name, father name, making it bold 14. Okay, first making it bold 14. Clicking on okay, you can see the size has been increases, and we are also increasing the size of this. Okay, right click on this properties. Okay, it's not showing, so let me remove this. After that, let me try it again. And there you can option of bold 14. Okay, close, and again we are changing it to the 1x1. Okay, this one is not showing. To increase the size, leave it. Let me increase this the bold 14. Okay, close. Now this part of the our form has been created. Now for the here we need email. You have to take the email from the user. Email. Okay, email. After email we need a label to take the blood group of that user. The text blood group. Okay, after blood group we need another label for the city and which city the user live. Okay, after city we need another label to okay get changes. So for that again let me set to here. Now let me edit text, and for the city after that complete address. Okay, now we are going to increase the size of this, making them bold 14 and making them bold 14. Okay, for this we also need a particular field for them. So for the email, I'm taking a text field here and increasing the size to the 162. And for the blood group, we are taking a combo box here. And you can see, okay, this means checks box, combo box we needed. Okay. And increasing the size of this. And after that, we need a city for city. So for that we are taking a text field. Okay, we are also increasing the size of this, and after that we need a text area for complete address. Okay, now we have to increase the size of this, making them bold 14. Okay, let's close this. We are also increasing the size if it's possible. Yeah, can see that bold 14. Okay, close it. Now let me edit this text. Edit text, remove this, and for this we are also editing and for the blood group we are writing here, just remove this all, E positive for the second, A negative, and for the next one A B positive, so B negative for the next, O positive, O negative, AB positive, AB negative, and you can now add more. Okay, so I just said this. Okay, let me close this. After that, you can see our form has been completed. Now we need another separator. Okay, so for the separator, we move here, swing menu, and here I'm setting this separator. Okay, so after adding separator, here we are adding three buttons here. The first button is for save, and you can see the first button for the save, and the second button is for reset. Second button is for the reset, and the last to close this application. Now rename, let me rename this, save. Okay, after that reset. Okay, and the next one is close. Okay, for the first we are increasing the size of this, we are making it bold 14. Okay, close. And in the save, I am going to insert an icon, save. You can see save png is available. If you need these png images, or so you just need to go to the description, I already provided the link. Okay, reset. Okay, stock search save print. This should be a reset button. Okay, so there is an update details button. You can see that close. You can see at last we are setting for this, and exit application name of that png image. Okay, now you can see that our form has been created. Okay, so let me remove this, let me retext and remove this one from here. And okay, after that we are have to change this layout. We are setting the absolute layout here. You can see layout has been changed. After that we inserting a label here. Okay, going to properties, and here I am changing. Okay, here I am inserting an image in the background, all page background. You can see, close this. Now let me, okay, you can see our form has been created, and after that we are removing the name of label, and just click on this and save it. And our front end has been completed. It's time to write the code for the back end. Before writing code, first we need to create connection, so that first we need to add the library. Okay, so here add library. I'm using MySQL database, so that I'm using MySQL JDBC driver here. So I'm adding this to in our library. So you can see added in our library. After that, for connection providing, we are creating a package whose name is project. Okay, after creating package, I'm going to create a Java class whose name is connection provider. Connection provider init, and clicking on finish. After that we are importing here, import java.sql. okay, and in this I'm going to create a class method, public static connection git con method init. Okay, it's showing error because we are not returning anything, missing return, but you can see the error. when we write the codes, it will automatically, the error get removed. Okay, so not need to worry about error. Here, exception E. After that, we have to write the try block. Like first, we need to load the class dot for name. Okay, in this, I have to write com. I'm using MySQL so that I'm writing com.mysql.jdbc driver. Okay, after that we have to create the connection. So for that connection, con.driver manager. Okay, dot get con, get connection. You can see first we have to write the URL. Okay, so jdbc mysql slash local host after the 3306. Okay, after that we have to write the database name. So first we need to create the database. I'm using password. My password is 123456. Okay, after that we have to create a database. I'm renaming it blood bank management system. Okay, so you can see that BBMS is our database name. BBMS is our database name. After that we have to write the default. I'm writing the default username of this database. So the default username is our root. Okay, so you can see, and the password, after that we have to write the password. 123456 is a password. Okay, after that connection created, we have to return con connection. Okay, and for the catch, suppose some unwanted error occurs, so in that case we have to just return null here. Okay, and you can see all the error has been removed. Okay, and after the creating connection, we need to close this. And for this, first we are writing the code for the close. So here, action performed. Let me move to this. Okay, set visual, just we need to set the false. Okay, after that we have to write the code for the reset action. And here I'm setting the set visible false, and we are sending the new visible is the same page. Okay, so true. Okay, now reset button is done. Now we have to write for the save. For before writing on save, we have to create table first here. So we have to move to the MySQL. Okay, so here we have to use BBMS. We already created our database. So create table here for the donor, and the first one is for the donor. Okay, donor ID int, we are taking here 10, and that should be primary key. Okay, after donor ID, we are taking name. We are taking varchar. We are taking to the 100. After that, we are taking father name. Also, we are taking varchar 100, and mother name varchar. We're also taking 100. After mother name, we are taking DOP, date of birth. We are also taking varchar, and we are taking the sizes to the 20. After that, we are taking mobile number. We are taking mobile number as a capital mobile number. We are also taking varchar Indian mobile number length is 10, so that's why I'm taking 10 here. Gender, where care, you're taking the size to the also 10 here. Okay, after gender, we are taking email, where care. Okay, for the email, we are setting here 100. And after email, we are taking blood group. Blood group. Okay, where care. And after blood group, we are taking just 10. And the city name, where care. Where city name, we are taking 100. And the address, the last one is address. We are taking 500. Okay, now our okay, it's showing error. Okay, in address we did not add varchar here, that's why it's showing error. Varchar, okay, is sitting clicking on this low. So let me show you the description. DSC donor. Okay, here you can see the details. Donor ID, this one is primary key, name, father name, mother name, date of birth, mobile number, gender, email, blood group, city and address. At last you can see all this are, and this one is filling matching. Now we have to write the codes to display the first thing. That one is our donor ID. It's come from our database, so for that we are using component show. Whenever this page is getting load, it will execute this code of part. And okay, so here we are writing catch exception. Okay, first we need to import MySQL, import java.sql. okay, after that import project dot connection provider. Okay, we imported this. After that, here we have to write connection con equals to connection provider. You can see connection provider dot get con is a method in it. Okay, after that we have to create a statement. St equals to con dot create statement. After creating a statement, we need a result set to check out the details. RS equals to st dot execute query. Okay, now here we are writing query to select the max donor ID in from your database. Okay, donor ID, you can see here you can see the field name donor ID. You can see here we're selecting it donor ID max from donor table. Okay, if rs.first is exist, means the data, our table is not null, then okay, in that condition it will execute it. If id int id, sorry, rs.get int. Okay, we are taking the int value, and here I'm entering 1. Okay, int 1, and after that id equals to id plus 1. Yes, I'm adding 1 value in it. After that, we are converting that value to a string form so that we can display in our string dot values of ID. Okay, in our level. So okay, and here we are just setting J level. Here the third one is our to display set text. Okay, and here str. And if our database is null, in that condition we are setting jlabel3 dot set text here to the 1. Okay, so if any error occurred, then just display it. Okay, j option parent dot show message null. Okay, so let me run this. So you can see here id, you can see that donor id, you can see here. Okay, new donor id 1. Okay, this one is at some different location, so we also need to set the location of this. Okay, so for that, first we need to change here, like going to the properties, and here we have to set the location, and the location option is here 340, and for the y-axis we are writing here 130. Okay, just close this and increase the size of this image, or you can say background image. Okay, now close this and let me run this again. You can see it will open in the different location. You can see it will open here. Okay, this one is a perfect location to open this. I'll stop this. Now we have to write the codes to save this in our database. For that we have to right click on this event action performed. So we have to move to this part of the project. Here we have to take that all the details from the user and insert it in database. So the first one is for the string. Okay, string, we are taking donor id here. For that we are just taking the label3 from and get text. Okay, and after that we have to taking the string and the name from jtext field 1. Okay, text field, that one is text field 1 dot get text. Okay, after that we have to take a string father name and j text field here 2 dot get text here. Okay, get text here. After that we have to take mother name equal to j text field. We are taking third dot get txt. After that we have to take the date. So for that, first we need to simple, we also have to take the date for simple date format. We are setting the date format here, and after that d for d format. Okay, and the format equals to new simple date format, and in this we have to write for dd plus mm plus y. Okay, this one is our the date format. After that we are taking a string variable for dop equals to d format. Okay, dot format, and we are taking here j date chooser. We having date chooser dot get date here, you can see, and in this way we are taking the date from user. After that we have to take the mobile number string, so for that we are also taking mobile number equals to j text. Ok
the JText field where we are taking the ticket text. Okay, we are taking mobile number. After that, we have to take the gender from the gender. We are taking it from the combo box. For that, first we are taking a string. After the J combo box one dot get selected item. Okay, get selected item, not index item here, so that we can get the text string email. Okay, equals to J text field, and here I'm just selecting 5 dot get text. Okay, after email, we are getting the text of email. Okay, after that, we again need a string. Again, string blood group. Okay, blood group. After we have to take this from combo box. Okay, J combo box 2. We are taking and get selected items. Okay, in it. And after that, we have to take a string, and for the CT, at last, the last one text field, and at last, we have to take the address, ADDRES address, and this one is we are taking from the text area. Okay, sorry. Get text. Now we have to insert this detail in our database. So for that, we have to first write to suppress our exception. We are using try catch because we are writing database program. Okay, exception may be generated, so that we are using this, and here. Let me minimize this all, and let me minimize this also. Okay, so that you can see in a better way. Connection, first we need to create connection dot connection provider. Connection provider, you can see, and in this we are getting an getcon. Okay, method in it, static method. Already created. Okay, so after that we have to create statement. Okay, statement has been created. Now we have to st.execute update. We have to change in our database, so that we are using execute update. Now we have to insert into donor. Okay, values. And one by one we are writing here the values. Okay, so the first one is for the donor ID. Okay, and for the next one is for the name, and for the next one is for father name. After father name, we have to write for the mother name. After mother name, the next one is for DOB, date of birth. After DOB, we have to write for mobile number. After mobile number, in the same way we are writing for others. Okay, while number, gender. Okay, after gender we have to write for email. Okay, after email, okay, let me write here from here. After email we have to write for blood group. Okay, after blood group we have to write for city, and so at last you have to add for address. Okay, now our form query has been completed and this query executed, then we also have to display a pop-up message. So for that, the option may I'm using the option dot null. Yes, change the first null and displaying a message successfully updated. Okay, and we are setting the visibles, setting the visible here the false. Okay, and new add donor dot set visible, and here we are setting true. Okay, and if any error occur, it's also show. Okay, so for that we are also showing message, and here setting null. Okay, so now we also need to connect this form with our home page. So for that I'm using this. Okay, here I just need to write new add donor dot set visible true. Okay, so now let me run this home page so that you can understand. Okay, let me click on add new. So here you can see that new form has been opened. Let me write this GURAB Kumar, Gaurav Kumar, father name Sunil Kumar, mother name Nisha Kumari. After that we are selecting the date, like we are selecting 1990 17. Okay, after that I'm selecting 888-228-1628. I am also going to select the gender here. I'm just selecting male. After that, email address gaurav@gmail.com. Okay, and here I'm selecting the blood group is O positive. After that, I'm selecting Patna. Okay, after that, Patna, Bihar. Okay, and I'm selecting India. Okay, let me click on save. Successfully updated. Okay, here you can see that our new ID you can see that changed to the 2. Okay, and when we insert new details in it, it changes to the 3. Okay, and you can let me show you the reset button is also working or not. Like I'm writing solder. Okay, let me click on reset. You can see that details has been removed, and you can see the new donor ID is also 2. And let me click on close. You can see the application get closed. So let me exit this application. So this is all about add new donor part. I hope you guys like this video. So please hit like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.